God. Number six is communion. Number seven is faith. Faith. Okay, you know faith moves mountain. So if you don't have faith, the devil will overcome you. Okay? So when the devil starts to manifest in front of me, and I cast the demon out, what do I use? My faith. Because without faith, I will not cast the demon out. The opposite of faith, what is it? Fear. Isn't that so? So you either fear or you have faith. We must not fear demons because they are under our feet. The devil uses two weapons. Can I just give you a secret? He uses fear and intimidation. Intimidation. So there's a T. Intimidation. It's a D. Dation. Intimidation. He uses fear and intimidation. He intimidates you with fear. I will kill you. I will kill you. What's he doing? He's intimidating you because he's attacking your faith. And demons, you know, demons can smell fear. They can smell if you have fear. So fear is giving power, giving demons power over you. The Bible says even if you have faith like a small mustard seed. Okay? So you can only use intimidation. It's how far he can go. He cannot touch you. I've cast out many demons. I've delivered many, many people. I have even stand face to face with a demon like this. They can never hit me or they cannot. Why? It's because I'm untouchable. Are you with me? So the Bible says in 1 John, because what happens here, when I do what I do, I have a revelation of casting out demons. I have a revelation. Are you with me? So what I do is when I cast out the demon and I deliver somebody from evil spirits, what do? I use my faith and I use the word of God. Are you with me? Can you see? It goes hand in hand. What does the Bible say about demonic powers? What does the Bible say about casting out the demons? If I have a revelation about that, what the Bible says about demons and casting out of demons, I have a revelation because it's in the revelation. Just move it around. Yeah, your first one. Here, look here. It's here in your revelation, your rhema, that you build your faith. Your faith don't get built here by the locals. Even atheists, they sometimes read the Bible. They know the Bible, but they don't believe the Bible. They don't have faith in the Bible. Are you with me? So when you move from logos to rhema, it's where your faith is built. It's where your faith becomes strong. Yeah. Are you with me? Because you have a revelation and understanding of the Word of God. So revelation, understanding, it is to give you faith so that you can apply this Word. You say, if I have faith and I apply this Word, I know this is what's going to happen. I have faith, I have an understanding of tithing and giving. So I have faith. I'm not giving because I have. I'm giving because of what the Bible says. It is more blessed. Blessings is in the giving. So my blessings is being released when I give. I have a revelation and understanding. So my faith says, give. It's not about the amount. It's about the principle. I give. And then I apply it. And because I apply it, can you see where it's going? Can you see where it's moving? Your giving, it doesn't stop here. It takes you to transformation. You will see change in your family. You will start to see your husband, your children change. You even don't know, you didn't pray for your child, for your husband, but change is coming to your finances, to your family, to your business. Why? Because of faith, you apply the word. You will never apply the word if you don't have faith. Are you with me? So your faith in the word will not be here. It must come to the revelation, the rhema. Just move it back. Rhema. Are you with me? So when I have faith and I cast out demons. So faith in the word of God, then I can do what I can do. I don't choose fear, I cast out the demon. And I'm a cast out the demon. Out, out, out. No, I don't fight the demon. I don't use my energy. Because I'm not spirit fight. My fight is not in the physical, it's on the spiritual level. And when you fight on a spiritual level, you don't fight the same like in a natural. Have you noticed when a demon starts to manifest, then you will see the believers, everybody will stand up and say, out, out. They will stand all around, out, out. That one say, out, out. In the name of Jesus, the other one say, the blood of Jesus. Confusion, holy confusion. Have you noticed what I do? I will say, shh, everybody quiet. Let me deal with this thing. Because that demon understands authority. Are you with me, people? Just go back again. Because here, I've grown in the dimensions, and in this dimension, the secret weapons, I've grown in rank. Are you with me? If I come into the place, the demons know my rank. And they know I've become an expert in a certain secret weapon. Yes. I'm still growing in this. I've been there. I can do this. I'm here. I'm still growing in the secret weapons. Because as a believer, I've grown from there to there to there. I'm more than 25 years in this game. I know what I'm talking about. Amen. Okay, just turn it around. More than 25 years, I'm in this game. Almost 30 game, 30, 25, more than 30, I'm almost 30 years. No, 25, 20 something years in this game. So I know what I'm talking about. Okay, can you see here intimidation? So he will use that to intimidate you. You will see, I will say, keep quiet, and I will just handle this thing. And the demon will talk. I don't talk to a demon. I will not allow a demon to give me information. Because the Bible says, the demon, their father, is the father of lies. Yes. Because they deceive, they are liars. When the demon says, I'm the demon of poverty, and I'm not going, I was sent to kill her. I don't listen to the demon. The Holy Spirit gives me information. What demon is it? Not the demon. The demon don't tell me who he is, what is he doing here. I even don't ask a demon, why are you here? What are you doing here? Who sent you? No. I say, Holy Spirit, you speak to me. And the Holy Spirit will give me, say, he was sent for that. That is this kind of demon. That is what he's doing here. That is his purpose. That the Holy Spirit, I get my information and my teaching from the Holy Spirit, not from a demon. The Bible never says we need to talk with demons. We talk to the Father, to God, not to demons. We cast them out. I may ask, who are you? But I don't do it. I just look at the demon and say, Holy Spirit, show me. And I will say, in the mighty name of Jesus, out. Or sometimes the Holy Spirit say, no, this demon. The one day I remember when I started to cast out, the first time when I cast out the demon, it took me, how many hours? 12 hours. No? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 4 hours. 4 hours. 4 hours. It took me 4 hours because, come here. Because I was here. I never knew about this secret weapons. I was here. And this kind of demon, he needed this weapon. Secret weapon. Are you with me? And I was standing and I was casting out the demon, and the demon didn't want to leave. I said, out. He don't want to leave. I use oil, nothing. I said, the blood of Jesus, nothing. The more I say the use oil, I later on that person was full of oil. And the demon said to Pastor Selma, Nama, take your husband home, man. He's tired. Look at him, he's tired. But I say, I will never give up. Because what I'm doing here, I'm exercising my level. If I'm growing in my level, then I get rank. If I overcome the demon, I get rank in the spirit, so he knows. Oh, say exercise. You must exercise your weapons. Exercise. So if you more, if you use it more, you become an expert. We must become expert. Paul says, I'm a master builder. Paul says, what you see in me, do, and what you heard from me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Who gives a man of such authority to say, if you do what I say and do what I do, God of prosperity, I read, shall be with you. If I say today, listen, if you do what I do and to do what I teach you, you will see God will be with you. You will say, who am I? You are just a man like me. It's only a man of authority who can speak like that. Are you with me, people? And then when I move here, the Holy Spirit said to me, you, and now the other weapon is the midnight hour weapon. The specialized, okay, secret weapon. I'm going to come to that. Don't worry, we're going to come to the secret weapons, okay? That is why certain hours you pray. In the secret weapons, you pray certain hours. When others sleep, you pray certain hours. Have you seen, notice on the watch fasting group, the message I send sometimes, it's early hours? Have you seen? It's because I'm using that certain hours. The certain times I need to pray. Because it's a spiritual, it's my secret weapon. And am I getting too deep now? Okay. You want me to stop now? And then what happened? The Holy Spirit said to me, Herbert, just do that. And I just do something. I did this. And the person was far from me. Far. Say 10 meters from me. I was doing this. And the demon said, Anna, you hurt me. I thought, what am I doing? I'm just doing what the Holy Spirit said. The Holy Spirit said, just do this. Do this. You heard me. I thought, I didn't say the name of Jesus. Nothing. And the Holy Spirit was taking me into the secret weapon. And the Holy Spirit said, I'm giving you a secret. I've got many secret weapons. And I know when to use them. You know, all of you know some of them is my sword. Okay, when I use that sword. Huh? Have you seen my sword? Okay. So it's just one of my weapons, my secret weapons. Secret, what is secret? You don't tell everybody. Yes. They think you are powerless, yes. But let the action comes. Yes. Then you take out that weapon. Yes. I tell you. And I did this, and the demons, you're hurting me. I thought, what is going on here? And the Holy Spirit, that time the Holy Spirit didn't tell me this, give me this revelation. But now, last night, he opened up all these things for me, okay? Earlier this morning. And I was doing that, and the Holy Spirit said, do this. And I just did. I didn't say in the name of Jesus, just do something. And the demon, out. Sometimes I use on this level, standard weapons, I use my words, my mouth. But sometimes the Holy Spirit says, no, go into your secret weapon, don't say anything. Just do some action. If I say, what I always tell you, can I go to action? When I say, can I go to action, I'm moving to this dimension. Okay? Sometimes when I move into coming to this place and I'm having service, you expect me to teach first. Then I say, move, can I do some action? Because the Holy Spirit says, the atmosphere is ready. Are you with me, people? Okay. This does not come overnight. It doesn't come. It is a price. A price. Just move. I think I need to stop here. You are tired now. No, I'm going to stop here. Faith. Must I do the last one? Okay. Let me just do the last two. The last two, then I will stop. Because I want to finish with the standard weapons. Okay. The number 8